the Model T story started about, I guess it's about 8 years ago. I was running a summer workshop program, and I had put in a request for a three-dimensional printer to be used in our machine shop, which cost $30,000. I put in the request to the dean of the college, and I got one of these congratulation letters, and then in came the check for $10,000. And we were heading over to our senior dinner, there's yet another Model T from the class of 1950, originally from the class of 50, it's class of 82. We were driving over to the Mountain Lakes house, and I said, "Glenn, what are we going to do with $10,000? And we're in the T, and Glenn said, "Well, why don't we get a T?" Which we went out and did. So we restored the T, worked on it with students for a number of years. That was great fun, and students learned a lot. And then Glenn came up with the idea and said, "Why don't we do a motorcycle?" So as we were looking at him, Glenn pulled up the Triumph Tiger Cub, and I looked at it and saw the name. I don't know that much about motorcycles, but I saw Tiger Cub, and I said, "We're Princeton, and it's a first Princeton freshman. What could be better than a Tiger Cub?" This is not motorcycle maintenance. It's motorcycle, because we're Princeton. It's motorcycle design. There's a huge difference there. We look at many years of the motorcycle, sequential years, which allows us to do some critical comparative analysis. If we think about the motorcycle as a system, you can break it into four basic systems. There's the structural, the mechanical, there's a network, an electrical network, and a process. I introduced this in this other course I do on the history of engineering. We use those four systems to describe all of engineering. So what I have here is a little gadget in the front. It's the ping pong rocket. You hook up, there's a little bit of acid. It says water on that flask. There's a little bit of acid in there to allow for some conductivity. We'll hook it up to a battery, two electrodes in the liquid. And then when you do that, you have the process of hydrolysis. So you break water into hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, so hydrogen and oxygen come together. Next slide. Open the valve to mix gases, puts them in that little chamber. Next slide. Ignite the mixture, bang. Okay, should we try that? So let's do this. I'll bring the gases in. Did that wake everybody up? The gas tank on the motorcycle serves two purposes. It holds the gasoline. But also, it's at a point in the frame that needs bracing. As you look inside the gas tank, you see that there's an internal strut there, and it completes the frame. So the tank is part of the frame, and it's also serving the role of holding the fuel. So it's doing two things at once. And there's a lot of those kinds of integrated parts that are a part of the motorcycle. This year, I am happy to report that I talked risk management into letting the students onto the motorcycle. So the students are going to be, if they get learner's permits, which means they'll be street legal, we're going to let them take the motorcycle around a track after we get the motorcycle restored.